After looking in the literature about some new possible techniques for analyzing compounds in blood, I came up with an idea of how to use a nanotechnology-based instrumentation probe to look at various types of molecules. For this initial study, we're looking at ovarian cancer. Just by early detection of ovarian cancer, we can save thousands of lives a year without really changing the treatment any. In addition, since this is a platform technology, we'll be able to look at many other components that are in blood, and so you can have a standard profile of all the lipids in blood, all of the hormones in blood, all the disease indicators in blood in a real-time handheld unit that you could actually put into your pocket. We have students involved in the research on all different levels, from the very beginning of helping to develop the proposals, of looking at the literature background, to actually performing the research, and then to publish the work that's being done. We have a commercial partner in this project, and they're called Aptigen. They're in York, Pennsylvania. And what they do is they make these little structures called aptamers, which are the very core of what it is we're trying to produce. These things are kind of like antibodies, but they're short strands of DNA and RNA that are extremely specific, in fact, more specific for binding a certain molecule than our antibodies. Plus, they're easier to develop, they're easy to store, they're much more robust. So we thought we might be able to create a biosensor using these aptamers. The Pennsylvania State Technology Transfer Network has been able to fund us so that we can get enough preliminary data to do a proof of concept to see if, in fact, what we're thinking of will work. So far, so good. With the data that we'll obtain from this grant, we'll be able to get larger grants from the National Institutes of Health and also from the Department of Defense. I do a lot of work with the World Health Organization, and developing countries don't have large clinical laboratories with millions of dollars worth of equipment and highly trained technicians. This would actually be a handheld unit that could be used in the field, and of course the military is very interested in this too, and we've been in discussion with them.